It's November the 7th, 2014. I am Dana Durford at the nuclearproctologist.org, and you can find these videos at YouTube, Beautiful Girl by Dana. And I say hi to everybody tonight before I start the stream. We're live streaming out of Beautiful Girl by Dana. And we got Mass Sterilization, Toxic, Albert, Shanikin, Elaine, which is Elaine, Candace, War Prophet, Bob Zavoda. Bob, I didn't get, they didn't put, there you go, we're up and streaming. Let me kill that. That's good, very good, very good, very good. Let me keep saying hi for a few moments. Miss Milky, who never stops unless her computer gives up on her. Candace, Fans Filtration, thank you, my friend. Broken Ass All in There, didn't make it up there. Sorry, buddy. Well, you gotta, I took a ferry home, but I didn't have to show an ID. It's the weirdest damn thing. Amthirst, Candace, Bob Silen. Yeah, it's a hard name to pronounce, that's all, no big deal. Just make sure I can go back a little bit, see if there's anybody there I missed out on. Albert. And I'm not going to try to read anything. I'll just go back and look for a couple names just in case somebody's sitting there. And I already got exhausted with the typing. Okay. Sean can't surf. I'll probably find you now coming up. Friends. And I'm just warming up. It usually takes me about 5 minutes to get into the second gear or third gear, whatever you want to call it. Yeah, I know, the photo I think is over the top. I had to use, folks don't know what we're talking about. We're doing an expedition up the coastline of British Columbia, Canada. And for 60 days, I got to take a ferry to leave where I live to Impel River in British Columbia, Canada, to get over to the island and or get up to the mainland, to Vancouver. I got to take two ferries. And you don't got to show no ID. The only ferry in British Columbia got to show an ID was the one that goes up north to Prince Rupert. And that was the one I was trying to get on. We paid with a certified check. They put the money back on my card, but they wouldn't let me on because I didn't have a photo ID. And so I take a couple weeks off. Finally went out and started on the boat today. Rained every day, but we're supposed to have good weather. I couldn't even get out of bed yesterday. I got up three times and passed out three times, and I went to bed again, and then I went to bed again last night at 10:30, woke up 7 o'clock this morning, so pretty exhausted, I guess. Finally caught up to me. And hi, Mark. And so Fukushima is like a big old dirty bomb. I don't take anybody, let's go over and let me see if I can find what a dirty bomb is on Wikipedia. A microphone, cup of tea. Put the cup of tea over there, Dana, before you get in big, big trouble. Big, big trouble. Okay, dirty, dirty bomb. Now that word, now the government's probably going to come look at that. I put BNB. You got to use Google to get a good. You get a good one though. Dirty. What I'm looking for, Beagle. Gonna put an O in there. Or Google will make fun of me. Oh, I never got it in there. Even worse than what I tell you. Here you go. Dirty bombs. Wikipedia. Dirty bomb. Dope. A dirty bomb is a speculative radiological weapon. Haha, that's right. Hang on, I'll make it a little bit bigger for everybody. Of course, you can't believe anything Wikipedia tells you. But, they do got, when it comes to government's narrative, they usually got something there. Of what a dirty bomb would be is pretty accurate. The purpose of the weapon is to contaminate the area around the dispersal with dispersal agents and use conventional explosions. And so they're afraid A terrorist is 10,000 Taliban and you created 5 million orphans. So who's the terrorist? I'm a little confused there. Huh? 2 million dead to get 10,000 Taliban? Don't even get me started. It's too late. No, I'll keep going. Not tonight. A dirty bomb is a speculative purpose weapon. Contaminate areas. Oh my goodness. dispersal. It's really bad. You gotta evacuate the city. The tires are gonna do it to you if you don't give up all your freedoms. The dirty bomb is just... Now, stuff that's at Fukushima, that's a real dirty bomb. Because the reactors... And it really did happen. Fukushima really did happen. I know. It's a shock, right? But Fukushima actually did happen. Yeah, that's... Fukushima happened. We've never seen that on our planet before. I don't know what to say to you. Outside, why ain't you concerned? Not to the people that's here in the chat room all the time. But if just a single reactor right alongside of the ocean, and we've never seen that before, like this one here, just a single one, loses its inventory, is that not a concern? When a single atom, an insignificant, you can't even see it with your eyes, a single atom will give you autoimmune deficiency or cancers in 5, 10, 15 years or less, depending on how hot that particle was. And the material at Fukushima was weaponized radioactive elements. They weren't for making fuel, because you only need, you just need a normal uranium and a little bit of old mixtures, and you can make all the energy you wanted. Still not safe, still not acceptable. These are man-made elements. So everything that comes out of that, by definition, is a dirty bomb. So if a terrorist runs down there and pretends he's a homeless person, and the Yakuza's come out and whack him with a stick and drag him off because they think he's a homeless guy, and you put him to work there because that's acceptable, you don't need no photo ID to go to Fukushima, and the terrorist could get big pocketfuls of radiation, and that'll probably melt him before he get home, but his cronies can come find his dead body because the Yakuza's are finished with him. That's a typical, actually, homeless person's demise now, and mentally retarded, and everybody else that are victims of society's fate. Japan is not a nation. Japan is a disgusting parasite that now has turned the planet into its host and will suck the life out of this planet, every bit of it. It will not relent. It won't slow down for anything. It's releasing a constant dirty bomb into our ocean. But if a you've been taught all your life that if a terrorist gets his hands on something, he can make a part of your city uninhabitable. And it'd be a catastrophic thing if it was to happen at, say, Times Square, New York or something. Well, how about when it falls out of the sky for 8 months? Because there really is melted reactors at Fukushima. There really truly is reactors. Right? The one behind me, that's a melted reactor. The one alongside me, they say, is the fuel pool inside of the building behind me. But you can see the roof in that shot, right? And they're doing that because everything that's coming out of there behind me is a dirty bomb. Everything that comes out of these places is a dirty bomb, period. And the dispersals, that was the world's biggest dirty bomb. And this model was Noah's model. It was only based up on... Hi, Pink. Pink Sapphire, folks, and you'll find her link below if you're watching this video later. And I don't shove her name out there near enough, just a few times. I gotta learn to do that more often. I apologize, Pink, because we love what you're doing. You're impartial. You're just reading the story and giving people another way of digesting it. And you do a really, really cool job with it. And we're very pleased to see you. And I know how busy you are and how much energy and effort and time and energy it takes to do the things you do. Miss Milky knows that too, and so do a lot of people, but I mean, that's two people that happen to be here tonight that I know for sure really truly gets it. And there's a lot of people, don't get me wrong, that put a lot of energy and monetary and effort. My site's got a couple of thousand musicians on it, and they might do that song 400 times and then record it and put it up, and they get no views, and I put them in my favorites, and they'd be lucky to get 100 or 500 views. But the model behind me, that model, is based up on just a single release from Unit 1 reactor. I'll show you Unit 1. It's a single release from that reactor. It's got nothing to do with 2, 3, and 4. And I don't know if I can find it. I can go look, and I'll take a second, I suppose, to find Unit 2, but not right now. And Unit 2 was a constant release. They vented it, they vented nothing, really, because it vented itself. It blew a hole out the side, one of the panels off, and vented out that way. It detonated, and the fuel pool caught fire, and aerosol burnt off zirconium cladding around the rod, the assemblies. And each assembly, there's 3,450 rods in the reactors. And no matter what they tell you, that's actually true. That's what was going on. And did I miss something in the comment section at the time? I don't know. I'll keep going on, Dana, keep yakking. So this really happened. That really happened. What you see behind me, that's real. I know, Dana, nah, it's not real, Dana. Now, you never seen a melted reactor on the planet, so maybe you should listen to some of the things people are saying. Maybe you should listen to Pink and Miss Milky, and there's Kevin Blanche and Thomas Ackerman down below, taking it to a whole different levels. There's Radchick, Christina Consolo below. There's Nubaru Magic down below. There's all these people trying to get you informed and get you up to speed, try to help you out. In the sense of, you got to take notice of this, you got to really put it into consideration that the world's biggest dirty bomb, not a terrorist now, well, you know, that's debatable, but because TEPCO is insolvent. TEPCO is actually owned by the government, right? They own the most shares, and they're controlled 100% by the government. They got all their little piglets working there for them. Until this all went screwy. But Japan is a disgusting nation. Not the people, but the government and the hierarchy and that dynasty, dinosaur media. The betrayal is shocking. It's humiliating, I would imagine, for the people, a lot of the people that work for the government at this stage. I know something like it was 98%. Didn't vote in favor, or when it was an act of support for more nuclear reactors in the country, 98% of Japanese government employees voted against Abe. That was like a secret ballot, or not a secret ballot, but the government didn't have no confidence in Abe. That was quite a while back. And Abe has an agenda. He's very tight with the mob, which is the Kuzus. And these reactors, because they're not going to do the job, so the job is up to us to do this job. We got to turn this, we got to ratchet it up, and we got to get this whole planet involved. This is a worldwide catastrophic event. The world's biggest dirty bomb is still going off. And every day there's 50 square miles of plumes coming out of Fukushima. That's over 1.8 million miles of plumes coming out of Fukushima since it happened. Square miles. And just imagine, like, the terrorists, just imagine if the terrorists got a dirty bomb and it was 1.8 million square miles worth of damage instead of just your city center. Would you notice it then? Because that's what's going on in Fukushima. Fukushima really, truly did happen. I know a lot of people have been lied to and told that it's like bananas, and it's like potatoes, and it's like you're drinking water, or your juice, and that's potassium-40. And your body has natural potassium-40. Everything you got is potassium-40. And that's got nothing to do with a chain reaction and a meltdown from Fukushima. Like, even the water they use in that fuel pool, that perfect symmetrical fuel pool inside this annihilated building behind me, Unit 4, this is TEPCO's official picture, and that's TEPCO's official picture. And when you think about how the system has constantly lied to you and told you it's like walking in sunshine. Now, you can get cancer from an x-ray, but an x-ray, they turn it on and then they turn it off. It's just like that. It's like this, watch. Just to make sure I don't screw up, I'm gonna turn my audio off. So you couldn't hear nothing. And then so I turned the x-ray off that time. And then I turned it back on. I left it on. Ah, it hurts, it burns. But what I'm trying to show you is it's that simple. You can turn it, it's not a weapon because you can turn the weapon off. The isotopes that are coming out of Fukushima, you don't got to switch for them. And you ingest them. And a gram that's coming out of there, because you got to think about the fuel pool, 3,450 assemblies, 80 rods in each assembly, 280,000 rods, each rod is 12 foot, and each rod is 18 pounds. And a gram of it produces more atoms than all the grains of sands and all the beaches on the planet. That's enough to give every creature on this planet cancer in 5, 10, 15 years. If they all just ingest a single gram's worth, and you gave everybody their little atom, here, suck it up. Well, everybody on the planet would end up with an autoimmune, really bad autoimmune. That could be dementia and Alzheimer's, and that can be leukemias, of course. That can be blood disorders. There's over 1,800 recognized diseases and injuries associated with radioactive. And of course, Dr. Raymond Guilmette, he killed Beagle dogs and puppies. Maybe I'll go dig him up. Hang on. Because I never does that. I'm a bit slack. Dr. Raymond. Raymond. Well, 2000 Distinguished Scientific Achievement Award. Dr. Raymond Guilmette, at Loveless in New Mexico, what he done was 137 in beagles of different ages. See Guilmette right there? Raymond Guilmette. A 6-week study was conducted using immature 4.7-month puppies, young adults, 2.4 years and aged, and male beagles to determine their modifying effects of the age and effectiveness of, they were using the Peruvian blue to try to suck the 137 edelman. Try to decontaminate them. 2 and 2 treated animals, 137 concentration in tissues untreated. And so the spleen, the muscles, the kidneys, right there, they were looking at what it was doing to them. And this was another one, the chelation, americium 241. And this was another study, time dose relationships, plutonium in dogs. You can't collate that one. And I didn't jump over, did I, when I was talking? When I was showing pictures, I didn't jump over, did I? Oh, I stopped it. Okay, hang on. That's my bad. Let me see if it'll jump. I'll refresh just over here. One moment, I'll be right on track. 1979, he's still going strong. Beagles, dogs exposed by inhaling aerosols, plutonium 238. That was a good study. And they got them all though first, poor puppies and dogs. Distribution, they call it sacrificing. Particles in the lungs of hamsters, rats, and dogs. What year was that? 84, still going strong. Inhaling 239 and big old dogs, he's still at it. What year was that? 1984. Did I turn my audio back on? Check. I got better double check here. Check. Yeah, probably. Hi CD, CB, yeah CB, right? And Luna, and Propaganda Buster. Yes, of course, man, we know what's going on with radiation. That's what we do every night. For 10 months, then we're out in the ocean, look at the damage, now we're back at it. Most people are aware. Biokinetics of inhaled 239 and beagles. What year was that? 1984, he's doing lots of studies. This was a different one, 1984. Did I double it up? 4 hours to 2 years after exposure. Hang on, what was that? So you can see this guy, he was killing dogs with alphas and betas and dogs inhaled aerosol. 1987, he's still killing dogs. 1987, 1,100 days of radiation doses were calculated for lungs, liver, skeleton, kidney, spleens, blah, 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 blah. However, doses for different respiratory tract, lymph nodes vary by a factor of 2,000. Other tissues received radiation doses, but at levels 1 to 3 orders of magnitude less than the lungs. Still kill you. They kill them quicker. 1988, still going strong. He was killing dogs with ingestions, loveless, biomedical, environmental research. Environmental research killing beagles all day. They're still at it. 1988, still going. Keep her going. Third group of 10 dogs not exposed to 239 were matched for age. The second group of 10 dogs, 2,000 becquerels, a kilogram, 239 plutonium, body mass, no signs of lung injury. Increased respiratory frequency, reduced carbon monoxide diffusion capacity. These findings indicate the alpha inhalation of lungs of man could produce restrictive lung diseases a long time after initial exposure. Right, these findings indicate that the alpha radiation will smurf you up real good. Dosimeter inhaled aerosols and beagles, 1988, 89, cesium compounds in dogs, applications of human exposure. Curium isotopes are major byproducts in radiated nuclear fuel. Oh, that was a curium, sorry. So he was using fissionable products on the puppies and the dogs. You want to keep going? Let me see what we got here. 1998, particle distribution in the lungs and lymph nodes of tissues of rats and dogs and the migration of particles containing the cells into the cells. Inhalation, risk from radon. Yeah, he was doing that one so he can come out and apologize in the media. And then he keeps back to killing the dogs with the plutonium 239. No slack, boy, you gotta kill them all before the beagles take over this whole planet. Who knows how many beagles he killed? Exposed dogs in middle ages, old dogs with those on match, 3 to 4 year old animals, old age, middle age, radiation exposed dogs, decreased responses. Hang on, I'm looking for something. Well, young dogs result in earlier than normal decrease in ability to tumors presence, concluding the inhaler's cells to respond. Yeah, so what he's doing is, I mean, these are dirty bombs, so if we're releasing that all over the planet, yeah, some strange stuff going on, that guy. Three animals exposed. Animals died or were sacrificed at 0.011111 in 99 months after inhalation. So what does sacrifice mean? They broke their neck and kill them, the puppies too. That's how it works. And they had other laboratories doing the same thing. And so they proved definitively, 100%, that the smallest doses, is what I'm trying to show you, for 35 years, these guys killed dogs with making them ingest 238 plutonium and using it as a human model, toxicity of inhaled plutonium dioxide in beagles. What do you think that really means? It means the same thing in 1996 as it does right now. I can trust me. And they were at, this is just one guy. He's a mass beagle killer. The guy from hell for beagles. Bone tumors found in 93 dogs were the most common cause of death. Lung tumors found in 46 dogs. Second most common cause of death, liver tumors, found in 20 dogs, were another major cause. What year was that one? That was 1996. No, Dana, it's okay, it can't hurt you, Dana. It's all nonsense, Dana. No, Guilmette done all these studies. We're only at 44. I got 85 of them there. 85 studies. Polonium 210 in a cigarette? Got nothing to do with what Guilmette was doing. He wasn't feeding them polonium. He was feeding them the shit you put in the reactors. Plutonium. Don't give me a hard time. Statistic modeling of the carcinogenic risk of dogs. The dogs that inhale the 238. Okay, hang on a second. Kind of reminds me. How about when people inhale that shit? That is only based up on a single release from a single reactor. What about the other three reactors? Yes, I know I'm yelling. Who cares about cesium? There's 100 times more strontium. Whenever you hear the word cesium, it's 100 times more strontium. Whenever you see the word cesium written down in an article or somewhere, remember it's 100 times more strontium, and none of them travels by themselves. If it's iodine-131, this model got iodine-131 with an 8-day, 1/10 of a half-life. They call it a half-life because it loses the strength by a half, but it does that by 10. So it's 1/10 of a half-life. But they'd call it a half-life to confuse you on purpose, and they don't tell you the difference. Oh, it only lasts 8 days. Actually, lasts 80 days. And once you got hit with it, you got ionized and radiated by man-made elements. These are not found on any other planet that we know about. The sun doesn't create these. And so let me keep going. But this is what Guilmette, he was feeding them these little particles. You can't see them. They're no different in those studies, right? So don't mind me, I have a smoke sometimes. It ain't no worse than your automobile. So you got an automobile and you're gonna criticize me? Shut up. Because you're 500 million times worse than me in a day than I am in a year. Before you criticize me. Your cigarettes are way more carcinogenic than anything, your gas, your automobile, anybody's automobile, is way more carcinogenic than a friggin' cigarette. You people are morons who go for that one. Get rid of the cars where you get rid of the cigarettes, morons. Comparative effects of inhaled alpha and beta particles emitting radionuclides from Beagle dogs. 1999, December, loveless. Here's your little Christmas present, you little Beagles. They're going to murder you. We're going to make you ingest this stuff, but not going to tell people that it's bad. What more do you want? What would you like? I'll find it for you, whatever it takes. To get you to come on board and realize how bad this shit is, why do you think the dogs were dying? I'm not yelling at the people here, I'm just yelling at the world when they say it's like a banana or like walking in the sunshine, and your body regulates all that. Right? Your body regulates that. It's got nothing to do with the radioactive elements. You can't get any more in you. If a Becquerel, 12 Becquerel, say a potassium 40 in a banana, big deal, it's what they call homeostasis. Your body regulates it like a thermostat regulates your house. Like your automobile cruise control regulates your speed. When you eat the banana, you off gas the same amount, so to speak, for lack of better terminology. But that's exactly what's happening. You can't get any more in yet than you have. You can't get any more potassium 40 in your clothing than it has. It won't hold anymore because it's natural. It means nothing. Everything on this planet is acclimated to it. That's why we all exist, is because we're already... like walking in the sunshine. We're already used to that through genetic superior selection. Why is it using these equations of destroyed, melted, and the fabrication of the nuclear reactor? I mean, that's fabricated. The one behind me is real, but that thing over here, that thing there, that's not inside the one behind me. Why are they lying about that and saying they're getting fuel rods out of something like that? Like that? Inside of that, why would they tell you it's perfect? Because they think you're a friggin' moron. And if you believed it, you're gullible. Or if you got an education, you're evil. Because you know better. Buckyballs are good for you. Sean can't surf. And buckyballs is where they spray salt water on the destroyed melted reactors. Right? And so they sprayed salt water in on that reactor, and I'll jump back. They sprayed salt water on that reactor and they created these balls, and they ingest a particle or an atom from the reactors and become like little nuclear engines. Very bad stuff. Dana had a cigarette. There you go. That's unusual for me lately. Such a long day. just a quick note. Here's what they said the Russians, the Ruskies were going to do to you. That's the fallout from the Ruskins if they ever come to war, nuclear war. Here's what they done in a single decade, 51 to 61. Each of these lines are two bombs that were set off at least, and the wind went the same direction. That's what they done to you to protect you from that. Right? They created massive radioactive fallout so the Russia wouldn't do it to you. And then they got all this waste temporarily stored all over your country because they don't know what to do with that, because it's got nothing to do with bananas. Right? If it was anything to do with bananas, they wouldn't be storing it in all these spots. Looking for a spot like Yukon Mountain to put it all in, right? Where the hell did that other map go? What the hell do I know? Hang on. I'll go get one. Well, you think about how much is actually there. I'm looking for those maps because I know I got an extra one there. There you go. Am I lucky enough to have a different one? No. Same one, Dana. One more time. Hang on, folks. Ugh. I know I got another one there, a yellow one. There he is. Gotta make him the right size. There we go. I'll bring this picture up. He's supposed to be right there. And so now, then you're talking about all the other spent nuclear fuel. A gram of it. A gram of it. It's enough to give everybody cancer if you gave them all an atom. It probably wouldn't kill them, but it would give them a good cancer, a good tumor. If they didn't get surgery, it would probably kill them. These particles that we're talking about from Fukushima are different, though. Completely friggin' different. They use missiles from silos that had already went through a chain reaction. By proxy, they're 2 million times worse. You go up and look it up on the, you'll see that in the mainstream media. MOX fuel, look it up. MOX fuel, 2 million times worse. And just because this reactor number one is not as destroyed as reactor number four just showed you, doesn't make it any less evil, any more or less wicked, any more or less dangerous, any more or less important and urgent. No, not at all. It's just as important and just as urgent as, what's going on here? Okay, well, let me come back over to Dr. Raymond Guilmette, one of your trusted scientists. He's been up on the media. The media likes to use him to say none of you came over from Fukushima, none of the iodine came over, because the jet streams are not real, I guess. But in 1999, let me keep going for a second. Let's find something. That's Raymond Guilmette there. That's the Guilnutty there. Dr. Raymond Guilnutty. Guilmette, I mean. Loveless Respiratory Research Institute. And what he does is he kills dogs for a living. Beagles, he gives them plutonium and gives them cancer. Pretty nice guy. You feel safe having him for a neighbor? Wouldn't have to worry about shit. He go out and kill whatever coming around. That guy, he got no conscience. But at lower doses, dogs exposed, lungs were the sole target organ. So they were targeting inhaled beta particles emitter can induce cancers in lung-associated lymph nodes and hearts at these larger absorbed radiation doses. He got the 2000 Distinguished Scientific Achievement Award. Uh-huh. Yeah, that's right, for killing all those dogs. And so he fed all those dogs little tiny aerosol particles, and just the releases from unit one, they don't bother telling you about unit two, unit three, unit four, telling you about the 1,800 tons that atomized an aerosol in another city in Japan, or the other releases that from the other reactors that couldn't go into a cold shutdown, are not into that model. But on top of that model, see, when they sprayed salt water on the reactors and created all these buckyballs 40, 50 days in a row nonstop, these sulfur carbon hydrogen peroxide buckyballs. These things are just on a mat. Like, there was enough created with the salt water. If you could see them, you couldn't see each other. If they actually had a color, and that's the problem with radiation. You can't smell it or see it or hear it or touch it or do anything with it. You can't sweep it up. There it is. Gonna get it out of the way. No. 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 And so these are really deadly hot particles because they used missiles from silos and put them through the chain reaction again. That's what makes this so twisted and demented. Besides the fact, killing puppies? Really? Okay, we're back to Guilmette 8. Back to the dirty bomb. So, let me see. Effects of a dirty bomb, accidents with radioactivity, public perceptions, construction, obtaining material for a dirty bomb. Way to go, Wiki. Possibility of terrorist groups using a dirty bomb. Shouldn't they be looking at TEPCO? The present assessment of the possibility of terrorists using a dirty bomb is based on cases involving one terrorist organization, namely Al-Qaeda. Al-Qaeda, 10,000 people, you killed 2 million. Time to give it up. You fired 5.5 million rounds a month to get... There we go. Dana goes again. You can't stop me now. Too late. You fired 5.5 million rounds a month in Iraq. About 2 million of them came from McAllister bomb manufacturing facility in Oklahoma. And they were all, they only make is dirty bombs. Your Abrams tank, that's all it fires is dirty bombs. Your Warthog, your A-10 Warthog, that's all it shoots is dirty bombs at the rate of around a ton and a half a minute. And that's the Animosity equivalent of 71 Nagasaki bombs worth of radiation released in Afghanistan and Iraq to get 10,000 Taliban. You burned off 5.5 million rounds a month to get 10,000 people. You are the worst shot imaginable. You are useless. No wonder you fucked up the whole country. No wonder you got 5 or 6 million in refugee camps, 3 or 4 million missing, 5 million orphans, millions dead. You got everything destroyed to get 10,000. Because you're afraid you're going to get a dirty bomb. Right? This group, in part due to the attention, just because the attention of this group, 911. Don't even start me on that one. The present assessment of possibility of terrorists using dirty bombs based on cases involving one terrorist organization. One. The same one, you got 29,000 rapes a year in the military for over a decade, 280,000 rapes, 290,000 rapes, raping your own. How many are you raping in the countries you're occupying? In the refugee camps, with the millions in the refugee camps, to get 10,000 people. And now you're going to demonize everybody on the planet because they might get a dirty bomb. And you went out there and you fired 5.5 million rounds a month. And half of that was probably dirty bombs. And your rah, 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 patriotism, nationalism, that you're going to support the troops. What about the 5 million orphans? To get 10,000 people. How are you sleeping at night? How can you do that? See, you don't want to get me started. But 5.5 million rounds a month? What the freak were you shooting at? How stupid are you? I thought you got some basic training in the military. Obviously, you don't even know which way to point the fucking gun when you fired 5.5 million rounds to get 10,000 people with AK-47s and they're going to fire 30 rounds of clips. And you got fighter jets. And Black Hawk helicopters, and drones, and satellites, and aircraft carriers, and you got a billion a man budget to pay for all that shit. Have you people lost your minds? But Fukushima, my friend, possibility of a terrorist. And so, dirty bomb. Let's see what a dirty bomb looks like on Google. Here, Google. Google. Yeah, you know, they gotta come in and take all your freedom away. They gotta come take all your freedom away. Here you go, here's a dirty bomb. I think someone painted the bomb white. That's pretty smart. Well, a dirty bomb right now is what we're doing to this planet. And these models are only based up on a single release from one reactor, not a constant release for 3.5 years. Imagine you put that in a model from Unit 1 only, because that's only from Unit 1 from a short release. Not Unit 2. They never put Unit 2 in there. And they never put Unit 3 and 4 into the model. Right? They never put those units into this model. This model is just a short release. That is a dirty bomb. You tell me that's not a dirty bomb. You say, it's okay, Dana. Well, a terrorist does it in a city. That's a dirty bomb, Dana. Right? The terrorist went into the city. That'd be a dirty bomb, Dana. And he took a couple of grams or a pound of it, and he would ruin a bunch of the city. Well, it's no different than the stuff behind me. Well, you never even seen that, did you? Like, it's okay to say, Dana, dirty bomb. The terrorist, Wikipedia, gonna get a dirty bomb with a couple of grams and put it in the city. Right. I just done that for a laugh, by the way. But that's not a dirty bomb. That reactor one, that's a dirty bomb. Everything that comes out of there, if you put an explosive on it, you wouldn't have picked up a fragment. You'll be in a lot of friggin' trouble before you get to the next stage, I can assure you. But if you manage to get that far, that's a dirty bomb. You dig up the soil, you put an explosive in it, anywhere in Japan, literally, you got a dirty bomb. That's not a joke. The radioactive fallout, the disposition that I keep showing you over and over and over and over, right, from that model, well, let me see, what do we do with you? Well, you know what St. Paddy's Day is? St. Paddy's Day is where they go put some buckets of dye in the river. And I want you to think of Fukushima as putting 1,000 pounds of dye in the river every minute, 1,440 minutes a day. In this river, it's thousands of miles long. For 3.5 years, you're gonna put this dye in, it's not gonna lose its ability to be ugly looking and be bright. And if it gets picked up with rain, the rain will be the same color. In 3.5 years, if you go down that 4,000 mile river, how far down that river, when you're putting 1,000 pounds a minute, you had a pickup truck with 1,000 pounds, 1,440 pickup trucks every day, dumping 1,000 pounds of dye in the river that won't change color for 1,000 years. Would you get it then? Huh? Would you? Yeah? Maybe? Huh? No. That's what I'm trying to say to you, is how many ways I can explain, this is a dirty bomb. Every way you look at it, it's a dirty bomb. Everything about it, right? These are dirty bombs they're dumping in the ground. These are dirty bombs that will leach into your water table. These are dirty bombs that will, at some point, can go into a chain reaction all on their own. Look at a nuclear explosion in the back of this postcard. Look at it, what they've done to you. And am I on it? Look what they've done to you, right? They're worried about the Ruskies. Meanwhile, this is what they've done to you with the testing, with the testing, right? For 10 years only, not counting 70s and 80s and everything else. But this is what they're worried about Russia might do to you. And this is not the accumulation of everything that I'm showing you, what they got done to themselves, what they've done to their own country, in the name to protect you. And they just create this, they've done it to each other. And every country out there is doing it to each other. And this is not sustainable any longer. What Fukushima got done is Fukushima has pounded this planet from the melted reactors. And it's pounding the planet. And that model is off by a couple of million. And it's not stopping. That model should be a couple of million times that, whatever it is there, including, you know, up to 2,000 elements that are man-made. Only 262 are natural radioactive elements, and we've created over 2,000 that we know about, not counting what all the other countries of isotopes and elements they created. Who friggin' knows, right? Well, Nevada test site, Yukon Mountain Project, that's their last great white hope. And they can't do it. Look at the chemtrails in the sky. Keep the radiation down. The regions. But look at, this is what they got all their hope in. WHIP was the other one. Look at Honeywell. Now they come out and they said they should have had an alert at Honeywell down in the United States. Remember that? That big release? They said maybe a point escaped. That was yesterday at Reuters. So they come out and just lie to you. Just lie. Total disrespect. Look at this. These are all dirty bombs. Honeywell was a big dirty bomb going through that community. And you need special equipment to find it. This is location of spent nuclear fuel and high-level radioactive waste destined for geological disposal. And their great hope was Nevada test site, Yukon Mountain. That just failed. So they got nothing to do with it. Because it's not like bananas. And it's friggin' dangerous. And just because it happened in those spots up there didn't mean it didn't go through all the country, because that's what the wind does. That's what they said Russia's going to do to you. And look what Sellafield got done. It's coming out of Sellafield and going down and over the other countries and going across the Atlantic. From the MOX fuel in Sellafield melted 4 million liters a day, hemorrhaging into the ocean. These people are evil and idiots. Think about what they're doing. But if a terrorist gets hold of it, it's different. Oh, hey God, we got to take away all your rights, all your freedom, and we got to go get Al-Qaeda. There's 10,000 of them to cut somebody's head off, Dana. Yeah, but you got 5 million orphans. You got 2 million dead. It's like America coming to Canada and wrecked the entire country. Right from one end to the other end, 33 million people, wreck it all, kill a couple of million of them, put 5 million of them in refugee camps, 5 million orphans, wreck every infrastructure, every bridge, every city, level it to get 10,000 gangbangers. That's what you've done. That's your war on terror, the endless war. And you created all those orphans going to grow up and fucking hate you. And rightfully so. That's what you would do. And so there's going to be blowback from something like that, and that's what they're counting on. Have a look at that. I come for the children. That's exactly what he done. That's what nuclear does. It affects kids 100 times more, see, per dose body weights, right? The way they calculated it. Do I gotta go back and show you Dr. Raymond Guilmette, he's 84 peer review studies again? No, take my word for it. Look, they got the troops radiating, the troops, go on now, get up and walk over there, you little sissies. Are you a tough soldier or not? Are you fodder for the death machine or not? They dump it in the oceans because they don't know what to do with it. Because they don't know what to do with it. Right? That's why they got those sites. That's why they got that. They don't know what to do with it. That's why they got that. Because they don't know what to do with it. That's why they got that map. Because the Russians might know what to do with it. But they can't be any more maniacal than what they done in the first decade of testing to their own country. So the Russians wouldn't do this to them with fallout. Here's the Russians' model. Here's Russia. What the Russians might do to you if you're not careful, if you don't fear them, if you don't give the American military all the power immediately, Russia might do that to you. So they got to do this to you because the Russians might get you first. Right? You got any idea how fucking stupid that is? And then you got to create all this hell, and everything is vented in your community. That's all. Every one of these sites are dirty bombs. That's what a dirty bomb is. It's releasing this radioactive elements into your community. That's what all that is. Dirty bombs. That's what a nuclear power plant is. A dirty bomb. That's what it all is, folks. And then they come out and told you decade after decade after decade after decade, and told your children, and told those children's children, those children's children, and now they're telling your children, that is like bananas. And a Geiger counter, you can't find potassium-40 with a Geiger counter. That Geiger counter, if it finds something in that shit, it's man-made. It's never supposed to be out. That's why you have these geological deposits one of these days in a couple of million years. They're going to get one. They're going to put all that shit in them. Till then, they're going to let it hemorrhage into your community because they think you are an idiot. Because they don't think you got any guts. They don't think you got any smarts. They don't think you're able to figure it out. They don't think, they think, even though you know there's three military reactors, they're just going to include a model from just a single release from a single reactor, not the other three reactors. No, forget about that. There are way worse damage. No, we'll just show, this is NOAA model. This is your government's model, and they're only showing two elements, not the other elements. Single release from a single reactor, ignore the ongoing releases. This is aerosol only. The ocean at 131 days hit your coastline, and every day behind that, 130 days behind that, was another plume. This stuff doesn't dissolve. This stuff will go right back to Japan. It'll be just as strong when it left as it will when the ocean currents bring it back during 20 or 30 years. If it's liberated when it hits your coastline in the same convection, evaporation, picked up in rainstorms, showed a smashing on the coastline, as it falls on the ocean, it annihilates the phytoplankton, the krill, the pods. You got to realize that the basis of the food chain is what you want to look at first. Anybody look, any studies on tuna are useless. Any studies on fish are useless. Well, you know, you got to do them anyway. But if you really wanted to see it, you should have been doing the ones on the most vulnerable parts of the ocean. The tidal zones, the nursery of the ocean, the tide pools, the intertidal zones, the high tide zones, the insects, the migratory creatures, the dependent animals upon the shoreline. You should have done studies on them. Not out there in the middle of it. Oh, the tuna swam from Japan, boys, and it came all the way over here. My goodness, did it have radiation, Dana? I don't care. I really don't care. Because you can get lost in that conversation forever and ever and ever. The minute you go look at the tidal pools, you see that 6,500 species of invertebrates with no backbones are missing. That got my attention. That keeps me up at night all the time. And by the way, we're heading back out, I think, on the 18th. We're going to take off. I don't know. Terry doesn't see any point in going. It's all friggin' dead. So I don't know about that, what that's all about, but some people turn to religion, some turn to alcohol, some just give up. Some turn to drugs in times of great stress. And some have hope. And some keep the fight alive. And some push forward. And that's us. That's what we do. We push forward. That's all we can do. I don't know what else to do. If we can push forward and wake up the planet and get the planet get in their faces, we just might have some kind of way forward in the future. If we don't, we don't have a way forward. If we just sit there and suck up the lies, say, we'll be okay, the government will take care of me. You're the most gullible thing imaginable. You're the perfect victim. Your job under your constitutions, your Magna Carta's, your Bill of Rights, is not to sit there gullible. It's there to keep an eye on these friggers and make sure they're not fucking you over. Your government put out a model and didn't include the other three reactors. So they abrogated their responsibilities immediately. They turned their back on you. They knew what they were doing. They had the education. They went and flew along the coastline and seen it for themselves with the stuff you bought them, with all the expensive equipment you paid for. You paid for it all, including their pensions that they're not going to get because they're frigging themselves. Hi, DJ. Sylvia. Patrick, anybody that I miss? Harry, just catching up in case I missed a few people. I don't know, I'm a little PI nip killer. And so what we're gonna do, I'm just checking to see if anybody here I can say hi to. I'm Thor Oz, it's a sickening mess, all of it. They should never mess with the atom. I can't pronounce your name. Iman Yurdaz. Yurdaz. I think that's how you pronounce your name. And people give me a hard time. And everybody, Well, Fukushima is real. I don't care what anybody told you, but Fukushima has actually happened. That's actually a real reactor, and that's not in the model you were just looking at. That's not in the model. And these two together, 3 and 4, you're just looking at 4, 3 and 4 right now. These weren't in the models that you were just looking at. Think about that. The one they put in the model, they used for the model, was reactor 1. It's missing its fuel pool. It was atomized and aerosoled. But they have multiple fuel pools in these buildings. So people see a fuel pool or a piece of one, then they say, oh no, Dana, it's all there. All the buildings are fine, Dana. No, it looks pretty normal to me, Dana. Hey. Right. This is the lie they've been telling you now constantly. I gotta come out and go to shit on this all the time. Is that fuel pool is supposed to be inside of this building. The building blew up. I mean, it went kabooey. And so like everybody you try to have a debate with. That's the only thing you can say to them. It's like the biggest dirty bomb on the planet. And it's contaminating everything in the Northern Hemisphere. And the Southern Hemisphere too. And all the oceans and all the estuaries. And all the rivers. And it's wiping out life on the coastline. 6,500 species of invertebrates without the backbones. You can flip up any rock on the shoreline. You should find a few of them. Don't find any of them. 480 species of worms. Never found none. Starfish out of 68 species found 5. One was melting. Out of 78 species of sea anemones, we found 5. All of this was very sparse. Once again, if the kelp weed, the kelp cabbage, the large barnacles and the blue mussels disappear off this coastline, there'll be nothing left. It's time to act. It's time to get busy. It's time to do things. It's time to rally this planet. It's time to treat it like the meteorite that it is. It's time to stop lying. It's time to stop manipulating. It's time to come clean before it's too late. Because there's no return. If the planet wakes up before the industry comes out and admits they're the biggest fuck-ups imaginable and that they're scum, and they never will, so we got to force it out. It's got to be forced out. And that's what we're doing. And it's shocking that we got to do this. But I mean, my goodness, Fukushima really did happen. I know. Dana. No, it's not bad, Dana. Look at it, boy. It's just a reactor. But if a terrorist gets his hands on a little tiny bit of it, it's a problem. If a terrorist gets his hands on it, it's the worst thing that ever happened to us. It's a dirty bomb, right? But it's okay if it's endlessly hemorrhaging in there. That's why the media, I have lost all utter, no respect whatsoever for media. Because they keep telling our loved ones and our friends and our families and people we know and try to talk to that it's like bananas. You can go back to the archives of what they done, talked about Fukushima, go to ABC or any of them, and you'll find that in the articles. Potassium 40, they were the ones who were supposed to flush it out and stop those people from lying. They were supposed to be the checks and balances. And they're the ones to say, well, not all fruits and vegetables are safe. And then they'll let these milk pieces come out and slander bananas. Banana never done nothing to nobody. Try to help them all out. Unit 5 and 6 weren't in cold shutdown. And TEPCO used the radioactive water from number 5 and 6. You gotta remember, it was broken, right? The walls below the ground were cracked. And so they kept filling up, and TEPCO kept spraying it, because they never had no water, because they had a big tsunami. And the tsunami took out 500 miles of coastline and infrastructure, and the earthquake took out the rest. Right? And so they just kept spraying that water for weeks and weeks and weeks. And that created these sulfur peroxide. Not that that's the worst thing down there. Well, it's the worst thing down there, but it's not the... No, even if that never happened to us, it'd be unimaginably horrible. But this makes it unimaginably, inconceivably horrible because it's not solutable in water. It'll liberate itself back into the environment. It's transportable to water, but it's not solutable. And it's just... 70 years of these fuckers lying to us and our children and our friends and our families and the media doing the same thing and backing them up. is why we're in this mess. And because all universities are full of cocksuckers that got the job to come out and teach our children that. These are fucking animals. These are predators. These are scum. These are maniacal scum. Every one of our institutions, every nuclear professor out there is a maniacal scum. Every ex-nuclear professor out there is a maniacal scum. Everybody that made profit off the nuclear industry and knew better is a maniacal scum. And I can name a bunch of them that are out there using their mouths and muddling the water. And the media pops them up there. The media only puts them up there because they're lying scum. That's all they want there. That's why the media put Dr. Raymond Guilmette up there, kill all those Beagles. They want to give him some accolades because he's a lying scum. Reactor 2 kept his top. 10 million times usual levels. There's no such thing as a usual level. Workers were evacuated from the site. That's when TEPCO pulled everybody off the site. Right? They didn't want to tell you about, because everybody showed pictures of Unit 2, but this is Unit 4. They never evacuated the workers because of that one or these two, rather. Right? No. Hang on, I'll show you why they evacuated the site. I got to show you that one. Unit 2. I typed it over there like a dummy. Unit 2, dude. Ublit. What the hell is a ublit? Dana? I don't know. Probably something that works at TEPCO, I'm sure. TEPCO! Heavy! In Chicago? Thank you, Heavy. And. Okay, let's do this the hard way. Fukushima! Dirty bombs! Let's go, Unit 2, Reactor 2, just see if we find. Frick, I done it over there again. Dan is a dummy. Done to me again. I don't know what I've done wrong. R-E-A-C-T React. Oh, mine doesn't do the O. Hang on. I know a shortcut. It's not a shortcut, but I gotta show you how we react to it. Come right back to it. I'll find it. Hey, Jesus. You gotta watch what you're clicking on. Because I got so freaking much of it. Let me see if I can find a big picture of Fukushima. I'll zoom in on number 2 for you. That's 3 and 4. That's 3. There's number 2 down here. That's number 2. Come on, Firefox, leave me alone. That's number 2. And radioactivity at 10 million times usual levels at number 2 reactor. Workers were evacuated, right? So they told everybody to evacuate. They had to evacuate it because of Unit 2. And then this picture would have showed up, right? And so they wouldn't have showed you the demolished stuff, right? They didn't show you that stuff. They didn't show you that one. The media, they would have said, no, they had to evacuate the workers because of Unit 2. Right, that's the game, see? And so you got the salacious headlines. 2 million times worse than usual levels. Because the reactor's fuel pools are always boiling off 120,000 liters a day with the spent cores into it. They take the reactor cores out after 18 months, put them in the fuel pools where they sit for 5 or 10 or 15 years, depending on what they've done to it and how many times they used it. And that's illegal to use it more than once. It's the stupidest thing imaginable because they're already vulnerable. They're already fragile. They already went through a chain reaction. They're supposed to be spent fuel, but they're not spent. Once they cool it down, they'll do it again. And the idea is to make weaponized isotopes to use for directed energy weapons. And so they want the wickedest stuff they can do. And all countries are up to it. Everybody else is up to it. Israel is probably the worst one out there by far. And Americans. But Israel is really bad. And they used it in that last slaughter in Palestine. They call it a war against people with no guns. People with rockets that got no explosive tips on it. They use jet fighters and tanks, 4,000 tanks, and helicopters and everything else. But anyway, the dirty bomb, San Francisco Chronicle has acknowledged that radiation might have something to do with it. Gee, you don't suppose? You don't suppose with all those reactors melting, hemorrhaging into the ocean all day, every day, we've never seen that on our planet, using MOX fuel might fucking have something to do with it? I shouldn't yell at you because you finally spoke up. But it's sickening 3.5 years later. You got 3.5 years San Francisco Chronicle of banana shit on your page and you finally come out and tell the truth. That's what's going on. You got pains of conscience. 5 and 6 contain 800 tons of radioactive water. They got 500 miles of coastline destroyed, but we're going to get in there in a couple of months with a mega float and take it over. Because it's like bananas, it's like potato chips, no big deal. We're going to go do that before we do anything else. Forget about the 500 miles of stripped coastline. We're going to get our equipment in there because we don't want those bananas to cause any issues. Too many bananas in one place could be a bad thing, right? Well, 906, I'll wind it down. Let's close it down. Sorry, folks, didn't realize I was... I thought I was only a half an hour in. Okay, good night, folks. Let me come down, say hi. Due to high volume, comments leading to disabled clicker to continue loading comments. Yeah, good night, everybody. Bob. Nepkiller, Lunar, Patrick, Sean Can't Surf, Stacy Lane, Toxic, Mass Sterilization, DJ, Miss Milky, with the old thumbs up. Yeah, I get it. There you go. Miss Milky's, I'm paraphrasing what Miss Milky got done there. M. Thirst, Bob Cleland, I'm Thor's Oz. Thank you for everything you do. You're welcome. I can't pronounce your words, so I'll just say. Thank you, Sean, again. Elaine, which is Elaine, folks. Really, really nice people. Really helped us out in a big and possible way and yet was able to do it. It's, and everybody else, you know, that got us up the coastline and got us to this stage. Don't think I'm slowing down just because I'm home for 2 weeks. I got 60 days on the road. I live in a hospital bed in a wheelchair. Trust me, a couple of weeks off is not going to hurt. But I can't take all winter off. I can't wait that long. I can't justify waiting that long to go up the coastline and document what's happening. We got that operation, and that's meant to get a job done. That's all it's meant for. That's all. I was out there all day working on it, making sure that I don't have to do anything once we leave here. Just keep going every day and get the job done and not wear ourselves silly. Isotope Hokey Pokey and BC Hunt Fish. Thank you. What's going on? S-Fat? I don't know. Candy? Yeah, that's okay, folks. Trolls will come. Trolls will go. Michael Clean. And BC Huntfish is good night. Thank you, Dana. Thank you. Stacy Lane, good night, honey. And Miss Milky. Everybody else. Amters. I just keep saying goodnight, DJ. Just try to get a few extra people. Looks good. I probably forgot Lunar, Mass Sterilization, CB, and a few other people. That's okay. I can still do it. I'll catch you folks. I'm going to be back again tomorrow night. I think my sleeping days are over. Yesterday was the one, I guess. Took a few days for me to settle down after being gone for 2 months, and then I finally crashed, right? So that's what happened yesterday. Okay, folks, hugs for everybody. We'll see you tomorrow night. Thank you for supporting Fukushima people. There's all kinds of links below, all kinds of people below. And I got them there for a specific reason, because I really think I learn a lot every time I go there. And so I think you should too. Take care, folks. Come on, Dana. You can do it. And no matter what they tell you, that's actually true. That's what was going on. And did I miss something in the comment section at the time? I don't know. I'll keep going on, Dana, keep yakking. So this really happened. That really happened. What you see behind me, that's real. I know, Dana, nah, it's not real, Dana. Now, you never seen a melted reactor on the planet, so maybe you should listen to some of the things people are saying. Maybe you should listen to Pink and Miss Milky, and there's Kevin Blanche and Thomas Ackerman down below, taking it to a whole different levels. There's Radchick, Christina Consolo below. There's Nubaru Magic down below. There's all these people trying to get you informed and get you up to speed, try to help you out. In the sense of, you got to take notice of this. You got to really put it into consideration that the world's biggest dirty bomb, not a terrorist now, well, you know, that's debatable, but because TEPCO is insolvent. TEPCO is actually owned by the government, right? They own the most shares, and they're controlled 100% by the government. They got all their little piglets working there for them until this all went screwy. But Japan is a disgusting nation. Not the people, but the government and the hierarchy and that dynasty, dinosaur media. The betrayal is shocking. It's humiliating, I would imagine, for the people, a lot of the people that work for the government at this stage. I know something like it was 98% didn't vote in favor, or when it was an act of support for more nuclear reactors in the country, 98% of the Japanese government employees voted against Abe. That was like a secret ballot, or not a secret ballot, but the government didn't have no confidence in Abe. That was quite a while back. And Abe has an agenda. He's very tight with the mob, which is the Kuzus. And these reactors, because they're not going to do the job, so the job is up to us to do this job. We got to turn this, we got to ratchet it up, and we got to get this whole planet involved. This is a worldwide catastrophic event. The world's biggest dirty bomb is still going off. And every day there's 50 square miles of plumes coming out of Fukushima. That's over 1.8 million miles of plumes coming out of Fukushima since it happened. Square miles. And just imagine, like, the terrorists, just imagine if the terrorists got a dirty bomb and it was 1.8 million square miles were damaged instead of just your city center. Would you notice it then? Because that's what's going on in Fukushima. Fukushima really, truly did happen. I know a lot of people have been lied to and told that it's like bananas, and it's like potatoes, and it's like you're drinking water, your juice, and that's potassium 40. And your body has natural potassium 40. Everything you got is potassium 40. And that's got nothing to do with a chain reaction and a meltdown from Fukushima. Like, even the water they use in that fuel pool, that perfect symmetrical fuel pool inside this annihilated building behind me, Unit 4, this is TEPCO's official picture, and that's TEPCO's official picture. And when you think about how the system has constantly lied to you and told you it's like walking in sunshine. Now, you can get cancer from an x-ray, but an x-ray, they turn it on and then they turn it off. It's just like that. It's like this, watch. Just to make sure I don't screw up, I'm gonna turn my audio off. So you couldn't hear nothing. And then so I turned the x-ray off that time, and then I turned it back on. I left it on, it hurts, it burns. But what I'm trying to show you is it's that simple. You can turn it. It's not a weapon because you can turn the weapon off. The isotopes that are coming out of Fukushima, you don't got to switch for them. And you ingest them. And a gram that's coming out of there, because you got to think about the fuel pools, 3,450 assemblies, 80 rods in each assembly, 280,000 rods, each rod is 12 foot, and each rod is 18 pounds. And a gram of it produces more atoms than all the grains of sands and all the beaches on the planet. That's enough to give every creature on this planet cancer in 5, 10, 15 years. If they all just ingest a single gram's worth, and you gave everybody their little atom, here, suck it up. Well, everybody on the planet would end up with an autoimmune, really bad autoimmune. That could be dementia and Alzheimer's. And that can be leukemias, of course. That can be blood disorders. There's over 1,800 recognized diseases and injuries associated with radioactive. And, of course, Dr. Raymond Guilmette, he killed Beagle dogs and puppies. Maybe I'll go dig him up. Hang on. Because I never does that. I'm a bit slack. Dr. Raymond. Hey, Raymie. Well, 2000 Distinguished Scientific Achievement Award. Dr. Raymond Guilmette, a Loveless in New Mexico. What he done was 137 in beagles of different ages. See Guilmette right there? Raymond Guilmette. A 6-week study was conducted using immature 4.7-month puppies, young adults, 2.4 years and aged, and male beagles to determine their modifying effects of the age and effectiveness of, they were using the Peruvian blue to try to suck the 137 edamon. Try to decontaminate them. 2 and 2 treated animals, 137 concentration in tissues untreated. And so the spleen, the muscles, the kidneys, right there, they were looking at what it was doing to them. And this was another one, the chelation, americium 241. And this was another study, time dose relationships, plutonium in dogs. You calculate that one. And I didn't jump over, did I, when I was talking? When I was showing pictures, I didn't jump over, did I? Oh, I stopped it. Okay, hang on. That's my bad. Let me see if it'll jump. I'll refresh just over here. One moment, I'll be right on track. 1979, he's still going strong. Yeah, beagles, dogs exposed by inhaling aerosols, plutonium-238. That was a good study. Had to gut them all though first. Poor puppies and dogs. Distribution, they call it sacrificing. Particles in the lungs of hamsters, rats, and dogs. What year was that? 84. Still going strong. Inhaling 239 and big old dogs. He's still at it. What year was that? Did I turn my audio back on? Check. I got better double check here. Check. Yeah, probably. Hi, CD, CB, yeah, CB, right? And Luna, and Propaganda Buster. Yes, of course, man, we know what's going on with radiation. That's what we do every night. For 10 months, then we went out in the ocean, look at the damage, now we're back at it. Most people are aware. Biokinetics of inhaled 239 and beagles. What year was that? 1984, he's doing lots of studies. This was a different one, 1984. Did I double it up? 4 hours to 2 years after exposure. Hang on, what was that? So you can see this guy, he was killing dogs with alphas and betas. And dogs inhaled aerosol. 1987, he's still killing dogs. 1987. 1,100 days of radiation doses were calculated for lungs, liver, skeleton, kidney, spleens, blah, 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 blah. However, doses for different respiratory tract Lymph nodes vary by a factor 2,000. Other tissues received radiation doses, but at levels 1 to 3 orders of magnitude less than the lungs. Still kill you. They kill them quicker. 1988, still going strong. He was killing dogs with ingestions, loveless, biomedical, environmental research. Environmental research killing beagles all day. They're still at it. 1988, still going. Keep her going. Third group of 10 dogs not exposed to 239 were matched for age. The second group of 10 dogs, 2,000 becquerels, a kilogram, 239 plutonium, body mass, no. It's November the 7th, 2014. I am Dana Durford at thenuclearproctologist.org, and you can find these videos at YouTube, Beautiful Girl by Dana.